went to a garden party to reminisce with my old friends. A chance to share old memories.
Welcome back. You're listening to Home Wizards, where we love to improve your home and improve your life. I'm Cindy Dole.
I'm Eric Stromer.
Now, you know, cleaning the bathroom is not one of my favorite things.
No.
Cleaning in general, although, you know, certain kinds of cleaning I think can be therapeutic. I do like to clean out the closet. I do like to, I actually like to fold laundry.
Here's my problem with all of
it. I don't like to clean the bathroom as much.
Yeah, I don't either. And I can't just do it a little.
Right? Oh.
Like, I'm the guy.
You're obsessed?
I have the OCD when it comes to this. And this is what made me a great contractor, because I'm really detail-oriented, but it's all or nothing. Like, I can't just do a little straightening. I start doing some straightening, and then I go like, you know, well, we might as well change the furniture around. And while we're doing that, we're going to vacuum everything. But before I vacuum, I've got to make sure I wipe down the baseboards. And then it just turns into like 50,000 things. So I either do everything or I don't do anything.
Well, you know, we all have those moments where we need to quickly freshen up the bathroom.
Yeah.
And we need to do it in a moment because maybe company's coming, or you just don't have time because, you know, whoever has enough time. We never do. So I thought we'd talk about some ways to just quickly cut down on cleaning time in the kitchen.
How do you do it?
Well, there's some quick little things.
Okay.
A lot of times it's stuff you already have around the house, but bleach and water. I like to have one of these little bottles that you buy, a spray bottle. You get them at the hardware store, and I have one in the kitchen underneath the kitchen sink, and I have one in the bathroom under the bathroom sink.
And it's just bleach in a bottle.
Bleach and water.
Bleach and water.
Yeah, and a half and half.
Cream.
But I mean,
bleach and water.
Ooh, and it's yummy. Yeah. Put that in your coffee, and it really cleans out the insides.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I meant half bleach.
And as it turns out, bleach is way more effective than a lot of the products, isn't it?
It's pretty darn good. I like it a lot. I mean, I use it for so many things. And I think when you have it there right underneath the sink, you can clean the grout. You know, you can spritz.
There's really nothing better for cleaning grout.
You can put
than
it in the toilet. You know, you can put it on the tile on this, you know, on your solid surfaces. You can put it in the shower.
Mm-hmm.
And it's great. I mean, especially if you let it sit for about 15 minutes while you work in other parts of the house,
right. Boom.
It just seems like it gives it this instant pop of clean.
Now, you don't actually wear a holster, do you, with the spray bottle?
No, I don't.
You don't have like one of those?
No.
Okay.
Baby wipes can be used. Baby wipes, if you still have them around, they can be used to kind of polish bathroom surfaces. And so I like the whole idea of having some of these things just right there, accessible, and then you're more apt to just do it in baby steps. You like that?
You know, I love baby wipes. I've been using them for everything. Baby wipes to me are like duct tape. There's like thousands of uses for baby wipes. You know, obviously the traditional use, yes. But to your point, cleaning knobs, cleaning handles, I use them pretty much for like cleaning out my radio in my car, getting all the detail out. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I think they work great.
You know what's great? Speaking of knobs, Pine Sol, or I should say doorknobs. Did you know that Pine Sol is really great as an antibacteria? And you use that, because when's the last time you've cleaned your bathroom doorknob?
Actually, very recently.
You did?
Because I've got filthy children.
Okay, good
you
for
know,
you.
And when they get colds and stuff, I'm the guy walking
You're
around
nervous.
With either the bleach or the
good.
Disinfectant.
Because that's where you get it.
And especially the refrigerator handles.
Yeah, all right. Well, good for you. You're on the right track.
Yeah.
You got it going. Yeah. So that's a good one to have. Ammonia is always a great thing to keep as a quick bathroom solution, because it's one of those treatments that's going to work. You've got a tablespoon of ammonia with some warm water, and you can use that to rinse down the floor, rinse down anything, and it's going to kind of get the scum off, that
sure.
soapy scum. Do you ever use just ammonia?
I like ammonia, but it feels so...
The smell?
The smell almost makes me feel like
nauseous.
I'm burning my sense of smell.
The nose hairs kind of come off.
Yeah.
Cotton balls. You got to have some cotton balls.
I got them.
And I love, you know, that's one of our favorite
I got them
things.
In my cheeks right now. That's why I look like Marlon Brando in Godfather. See that?
Thank you.
I could have been somebody. I could have been a contender. That's the wrong movie, but you get my drift.
Get it.
Yeah.
Well, so I love the idea of having cotton balls. Number one, we talk about this, to put some lavender oil or some fragrant oil, you know, as a nice air freshener in the bathroom. But also just using... putting bleach on cotton balls, and then you can use that for those hard-to-reach places to clean in your bathroom.
You know what else I use? Q-tips.
Yes.
That gets all the little
small,
nooks and crannies
and
those little... I'll do bleach on a Q-tip, and I'll get in the cracks.
You do.
That's how I do it.
Okay. Yeah. What about laundry detergent?
Well, I use it for my laundry.
Well, it's also a good idea to keep the mildew off the shower curtain.
What?
I know. I haven't
how?
Done.
What do you do?
Well, you wash the shower curtain and the towels together. Yeah. You actually put the shower curtain.
The plastic curtain.
Well, I don't know if I did. I put a plastic one in there. I guess it's part plastic. Maybe you just don't put it in the dryer.
All right.
But you wash your shower and curtain and towels.
If you shrink it down, it'll be like a washcloth.
Yeah. No, you're not going to shrink it.
And then if it gets ruined, you can always turn it into a rain poncho. Just cut a slit in the top.
Or it's like a little vest for your kitten.
Yeah.
But
Many uses.
Yeah. You add a half a cup of laundry detergent and then some baking soda to your warm wash, and there you go. And maybe even some vinegar. You're going to put your shower curtain in, and then you put it, and you basically take it out before the spin cycle, and then you hang it dry. You do not put this in the dryer.
Okay. Yeah, because it'll shrink, be small.
And it wouldn't
creepy.
Be safe, I
no.
don't think, to heat the plastic.
It'd probably melt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We love the white vinegar.
Boy, do I got to tell you, I love the vinegar. And I first was introduced to the vinegar in construction setting Sautéo tile, because vinegar pulls out the lime in Sautéo tile, that clay Mexican-looking tile. And it just cleans everything. Cleans off grout and thin set, all sorts of stuff. Then I realized it's great around the house. It's probably one of the most amazing, miraculous things I've ever used. I use it on everything now.
I use it at my coleslaw.
I use it on my... all sorts of things.
Things, okay.
Yeah, I'm soaking in it right now.
Well, you know, you might want to try, while you're soaking in it, think about putting it also in your toilet bowl, because you let it sit there overnight, and it's a great way of not only making it look clean.
It smells delicioso.
It smells good.
I don't mind the smell of it. It reminds me of Easter, dying the eggs.
You like it or you don't like it?
I do like it.
Really? I don't care for I like balsamic vinegar, the smell of balsamic, but pure vinegar.
You don't like the white stuff?
No, it kind of smells like rotten eggs to me. But,
okay.
But anyway, it's going to make your toilet smell clean.
Yeah.
Yeah. So give that a try.
I think it's safe for all surfaces, too.
It's good for mirrors.
And great for windows.
Yeah,
now question.
Uh-huh.
Do you use newspaper on your windows and mirrors?
My husband does.
I find it to be fantastic. Yeah. Streak-free
cleaning.
It's
better than paper towels, because all those little dust bunnies and all the fabric fibers, they start to kind of, well, they congregate on the glass itself.
I've tried all things. I've tried the window squeegees,
mm-hmm.
which I still use sometimes. See, unfortunately, I'm this guy. I'm going to clean the windows today. I can't just clean them. I got to go buy all the stuff that I've seen those professional guys use. So I go and I buy like the holster that holds all the sizes, and I got the sponges and the buckets and all the solutions, you know, and I do it once and it's like, great. Okay, that was fine. But then now I'm sort of back to the just newspaper and, you know, spraying the solution on the window, done.
I think newspaper's pretty good.
I think it's great.
The only thing is then you got the ink on your hands.
Yeah, I don't mind
that. Do you wear gloves? Rubber gloves or something?
No.
No? Okay. No. Well, anyway, so give the newspaper one a shot, and try a little bit of vinegar, one half water with half vinegar for both the windows and the mirrors in your bathroom.
All right,
it's good. It kind of
you're preaching to the choir. I'm a vinegar guy.
You're a vinegar guy.
Yeah.
Another really good thing for your bathroom cleaning, to make it a little faster, is to have wax paper in the house. Now, you know, who uses wax paper? Hardly ever, right? It seems kind of old school, but do you have wax paper in the house?
I do.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, I use it because I have these croissants. I have these croissants that I use. They're frozen. You let the dough thaw, and then you put wax paper in, and then you put the croissant on the pan, and then it doesn't stick.
Okay.
Yeah, but I love it.
Okay. So, well, it also is good for your fixtures in the bathroom. It's going to, when you have a little water and soap scum that comes in contact with the surface that you're rubbing, the wax keeps it from sticking, and then it gives the clean bathroom a longer life.
Really?
I know. Wax paper.
I had no idea.
Wax paper. Yeah. Kind of weird.
Okay, I'll try it.
Eucalyptus oil is another good one to clean the tiles, Mr. Tile Guy, in the bathroom. You use a little...
I like the smell of eucalyptus oil.
I love the... Yeah, you feel like you're getting a massage. You put a few drops of eucalyptus oil in a cup of vinegar and then some water, and you soak the paper towels or the old shop rags, and now you let the rags just sit on the floor for about 30 minutes. Isn't this a great idea?
Mm-hmm.
And then you wipe the floor with the towels, and if there's still some small stains, you can use the remaining solution to scrub the floor again. But isn't that great? It's going to clean the tiles in your bathroom, and it's going to smell terrific.
I love
that.
I'll try that one.
And it sounds like it's going to eat away at the scum and the junk without you having to work as hard.
Yeah, I got to tell you, my boys, you know, use their own guest bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe how bad it is in there. I walk in there with...
Like a sweatshop kind of a thing?
It's just, they're just like, one's a teenager and one's eight, and they just... You know, I don't even think
things
they,
are on the
I
floor.
I don't think they know there's a toilet in there.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, it's just
it's got a. It probably is kind of stinky.
Just open the door, put my arm in with a jug of white vinegar, and start dumping it in the floor. You know, and then I come in with my towel and I put it on the floor and rub it with my feet, and that's my first pass.
Uh huh.
You know,
I think you need some definite cotton balls and some of the lavender oil in there permanently.
That's a good point. Yeah, I'll try it.
Or the citrus oil is a good one.
I don't mind that either.
Yeah. And then finally, the mild detergent. I mean, don't forget that the walls and the ceiling in the bathroom can have some problems, and you can dust them. Or you can take a mild detergent and wash them and just be careful of the paint or the treatments and so forth. But those are some great little tips to keep
that's
the bathroom
great.
Clean.
Natural remedies.
Natural home things that you've got to kind of reduce the time spent on cleaning the bathroom. So hopefully you can get it done in 10 minutes or so.
Great.
Love Great. It.
I'm going to try this.
Now just put those sons to work.
Yeah, somebody's got to do something. Come on.
All right. When we come back, we have more fun things to talk about to help you improve the spaces you call home. So don't go away. Home Wizards, Eric Stromer, Cindy Dolan. By the way, if you haven't been to the website, go there. You can see all the great things. You can listen to past shows and email us at yourhomewizards.com. Yourhomewizards.com. The fun continues right after this.